Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So we Bengalis celebrate mainly three kinds of festival during Navratri. First is the Durga Puja, then the Lakshmi Puja, and then the Kali Puja or Diwali. So in today's video, I'll be sharing with you guys what all outfits I'll be wearing this year for Durga Puja, Lakshmi Puja, and for Diwali. So let's get started with the video. So the first outfit that I have here is this beautiful silk sari. So one thing that I would like to mention here is that I'll be only sharing with you guys what all outfits and accessories I have. In order to find out which outfit I'll be wearing on which particular festival, you will have to check out the makeup tutorials that I'll be uploading really soon for Durga Puja and the other festivals that I mentioned. So the first outfit that I have here is the sari. I'll be only wearing saris this time. So this is how the sari looks like. This is the achal portion, which is in dark violet shade, which has this beautiful zari floral design with and with this kalki sort of a motif down over here. And the same floral design continues on the border, on the top and at the bottom. And as you can see, I've attached very small golden balls. This looks very pretty with this sari. And the rest of the sari is this beautiful wine pink kind of a shade. It's a very sweet reddish wine pink, which has thread works. There are two kinds of thread works, the golden thread work and the violet thread work. I'll be pairing this sari with matching rani colored petticoat and this beautiful golden blouse. Now actually this blouse is of another sari. I have a half and half net and brasso sari in mehndi and pink shade. This was the blouse piece with that sari, but since it has this black and pink design on the border of this sleeves of the sari with this beautiful golden zari details, this looks good with a large variety of saris. And I think this will look really pretty with the sari that I showed. So this is my first outfit. The second outfit is another sari. Now I have two silk saris and one cotton. So this is my second sari that I'll be wearing. So this is a traditional Kanjivaram sari with the square and rectangle block printed details in the pallu and all over the sari with beautiful golden zari thread work. The same details are there at the borders, on the top and at the bottom. Now the sari has contrast. This part of the sari, the achal portion of the sari, is in navy blue and the rest of the sari is in firozi shade with the same block print motifs at regular intervals. It is not as concentrated as it is on the pallu, but it is present as in a panel sort of a pattern, as you can see. And I'll be pairing this sari with this blue petticoat. Since the silk saris that I have are pretty thick material, so I can wear a petticoat which has a shade more or less in the same color spectrum as a sari. You don't have to wear exactly the same matching petticoat. However, I'll be pairing this sari with this beautiful blouse. This came as a blouse piece with the sari, and I've attached this golden border motif on the sleeves and at the back, because in the front there will be pallu, so don't need to add the border. So this is my second outfit. The third outfit that I have here is this beautiful navy blue cotton sari. You must have seen me wear this in two of my videos. One is the Navabarsha makeup tutorial, another one is how to style a cotton sari with five different blouses. I'll be sharing the links of the video in the description box below. In case if you want, you can check them out. So I'll be wearing this sari, and I thought of creating a fusion outfit. I don't know, whenever I wear a cotton sari, I see a cotton sari, only fusion outfits come to my mind. I feel that the cotton sari can be mixed and matched in a lot more different ways than the silk sari. According to me, I prefer to wear the silk sari in the traditional way, but when it comes to cotton sari, I like to experiment. So I will not be pairing this cotton sari with a blouse, but I'll be pairing it with this beautiful yellow A-line kurti. My husband got this recently for me as a gift. आई लव दिस कुर्ती. इट्स इन कॉटन कॉटन मटेरियल एंड इज़ वेरी कम्फर्टेबल. इट हैज़ दिस रफल स्लीव्स विद दिस ब्यूटिफुल मेहंदी कलर्ड डिज़ाइन. इट्स मेहंदी, इट्स अ जंगली प्रिंट मोटिव विद फ्लावर्स एंड आई डोंट नो वॉट दिस एग्जैक्टली इज, बट इट्स अ जंगली प्रिंट मोटिव एंड दिस इज इन कंट्रास्ट विद द साड़ी. I think this will, this is not only looks good with the saree because of the contrast combination, but also because the saree has this rani color pom poms. The three color combination, rani color, navy blue, and yellow will look very good together. So I don't know how I'm going to style this one, because I have not styled any A-line kurti in saree. So it might be a little tricky for me, but I'll try nevertheless how to style this with different ways. Now for my accessories, first I'll be showing my watches. So I have these two watches, one is a silver and a gold. Whenever it's an Indian festival, be it Navratri or any other festival, we always wear lots of jewelries, either silver or golden. And I think these are the two shades that go with all kinds of outfits and jewelries. So I think these two will look best. So I'll be pairing the golden one and the silver one as it looks good with the outfit. I'll try and find out whichever looks better and pair it with that one. Now when my watches are done, I'll be sharing with you my earrings and my other jewelries. So I have these beautiful pearl detailed kundan earrings with this pearl drop at the bottom. You must have seen me wear this in my party wear tutorial. So I'll be wearing this, pairing this up with my outfit. I'll see which outfit I paired this up with. Next I have my bangles. I have my wedding bangles and these golden bangles which were gifted to me by my mother, and this was given to me by my mother-in-law. So we usually wear traditional wedding bangles after marriage, especially in an Indian occasion. So in these kind of festivals I'll be pairing them. Next I have three rings. I have this beautiful ring with this three flower petals with gold, you know, diamonds and in gold, and I have this another golden ring which is a bit simple and with a beautiful pink stonework here. Next I have two sets of Mangalsutra and a pendant with earrings. So this is a Mangalsutra I got as a birthday gift from my mom with this beautiful round details here at the bottom. So I'll be pairing this one with beautiful, these earrings with this little golden balls at the bottom and this beautiful flower, gold flower. I think this will look very good with the Mangalsutra. And another set that I have is this, another one. This also has this beautiful golden pendant at the bottom with this attached to this maroon and golden tassel. This was gifted to me by one of my relatives in my wedding, and I'll be pairing this up with these beautiful earrings. I think I got this from my in-law's side. I don't exactly remember because I got a lot of jewelries. Someone from that side, my in-law's side, gifted this to me, and I thought this will look very good with this particular pendant, so I'll be wearing this. So that was all for the video, guys. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so that you're notified whenever I share a new video. See you soon with my makeup tutorials with the festivals, and I hope you enjoy the festivals with your family members staying at home. Stay safe and stay healthy. That's all for today, guys. See you in the next video. Bye bye.